So good morning, my dear students. For the last class, so we were started to discuss the economic importance of the beekeeping. So why we want to rear the beekeeping? What are the terminologies? So frequently you may come across in the apiculture. So and the what are the cost differences are found in the apiculture? So we were discussing on those titles. So today we are going to continue with this, the second part of the apiculture, the bee life cycle. So you all know the bee life cycle. Bee is an belongs to Hymenoptera. Belongs to Hymenoptera. So therefore, Hymenoptera. So the if this is Hymenoptera, mean you can expect a complete metamorphosis. If it is a complete metamorphosis, so it is starting with an egg, then larva, pupa, and larva, pupa, and in the bee there is some differentiation in the life cycles. So because the only reproductive females are queen. So because the different caste systems are there, therefore the only reproductive females are queen. If the queen is laying fertilized egg, definitely you can expect a 2N. It may be queen or it may be worker. So depend on the selection and this the selection of this and the phenomena, right? The selection phenomena by the queen and the some circumstances. If there is no queen or if the population is going to swarm, means the population is abundant, so it want to go somewhere else to initiate or in a start up the new colony. So it can develop one of the worker. So right, one of the laid eggs, fertilized eggs as a queen by feeding with a special food we call it as a royal jelly, right? And heavy weeding plus royal jelly. If it is not feed with the royal jelly and only with the bee milk, it will be developed as a worker. Right. From the unfertilized egg, you can expect a drone. Right, so you all know the queen, the honeybees are living in a hive. Right, honeybees are living in a hive. So this is called as it's a home of the honeybee. So in the home, for the different life stages, they have the different setup rooms. Right, different setups room. So egg will be laid in the egg room. One it is be emerged as a larva, it will be called as a birth room. Right, it will be called as a birth room. So in the birth room, so if a honeybee has the four distinct life stages, egg, larva, pupa, and the adult. Queen lays the egg in different cells of the honeycomb. We call it as an egg chamber. This is we call it as an, is highlighted as an egg chamber. In the egg chamber, queen is laying eggs. Right, this is we called as an egg chamber. You can find it, these are the eggs. So once it is incubated for some time, for 3 days, egg will catch from this eggs, larva will be emerged as a worm-like larva. So worms, the worker bees feed the larva. Right? Worker bees feed the larva with the bee milk and the royal jelly if they want to develop this larva as a queen, right? Bee milks. As it is grow, larva sheds its skin 4 to 5 times, as we call it as a molting process. We have studied this one. The molting process means insta development, right? From the first insta, second insta, third insta, right? The removal of exuvia and it will become a next insta. In between the insta, we call it as a stadium, right? Stage we call it as a stadium, right? Insta and the stadium, the period. I would have studied in the morphology of this entomology, right? So on 9th day, the larva spins itself into the cocoon. Larva produces a cocoon and will become a pupa. So this is we call it as an egg chamber. This is we call it as a birth room. Here you can find the white substances. This is bee milk, or sometimes it may be the royal jelly, maybe. Oil jelly or bee milk. Right, in the birth rooms, First you see if it is matured. It like lavas matured. In the bathroom you can see that lava matured. So once it lava matured, it spin the cocoon and become a pupa. This is we called as a pupal room. Right, bathroom for the pupa. Pupa special, which is slightly bigger rooms than the larval rooms, larval chamber. Inside the cocoon, larva transform into pupa and develop eyes, legs, and wings. Right, eyes, legs, and wings. It's a series of development. Right, from the egg, it's a series of development. It will become an adult when it's reached. Right, these are the adults. So when the bee is fully grown inside the pupa. The fully developed compound eye, fully developed antenna, fully developed wing, it will emerge, it will cut the chamber and it will emerge as an adult. Like here you can see that video clips, right? So it shows how it is developed. Right, so this the video clips is showing how from the egg, this is the queen is laying eggs. So from the birth chamber, so right, pupa, the workers are taking care, right? Workers are taking care of this larva, mature larva, mature larva. Then these workers will seal the chamber to make this larva into pupa. Once this pupa, this adult will emerge. These pictures, two pictures showing. And this is a summary, how many days it will take from the egg to develop that adult, right? So for example, if the queen, right, so type of queen is, so until 3 days, so larva egg is a 3 days, normally for egg will be 3 days. Larval period of queen is nearly 5.5 days. Worker bee, nearly 6 days. Drone, 6.5 days. Cell capped. So the sealed by the sea worker, right, worker honeybee, 7.5 days from the larva, because at the time, so they can give the tremendous amount of royal jelly, full of food, right? So worker will become kept at 9 days, drone will be kept with 10 days. So pupal period of queen is 8 days, workers 12 days, drone 14.5 days. Right, queen emerged 16 days from the eggs. Worker in 21 days, it took 24 days for drone to emerge. Right, drone to emerge. So the fertility, approximately 23rd day from the birth, the queen is ready for mating and laying eggs. 23rd days, nearly 3 weeks. Workers not applicable, it will not lay eggs because and drone it's ready for mating nearly 30th day. And it indicates that you can see the queen complete the life cycle very quickly. Others are taking long times. Why? So if the queen is ready only, right? If the queen is ready only, it can produce a more amount of eggs. So therefore, the egg laid by the queen, the drone eggs, if the eggs is non-fertilized eggs are laid earlier and the queen eggs are laid later. If the queen deciding of which eggs they are going to develop as a queen is deciding by the later, therefore this life cycle is synchronized. Right? Synchronized mean drone will emerge early, queen will emerge later. So therefore, at the time 30th day and 28th day will be synchronized. So both will be at the reproductive stage. Both will be at the reproductive stage. So these pictures is clearly saying that how many days it takes, right, for each and every cast of the epiculture, right? Epiculture. So these bees, you all know, they are living in a hive, right? So this is a natural hive under the tree branch. You can see that parallel homes, right? Parallel homes. In the individual hive, you can find that there are parallel homes. So if you are domesticating this one, or if you are going to rear it in your home or yard, we call it as an apiculture, or maybe beekeeping for the only honey purpose or the broad purposes, you have to develop this type of chamber, and you have to give all the facilities. All the facilities. So why? So because in the hive, there are different setups will be there. Right? So in the top portion, always filled with the honey. Just below that honey, this is we called as a honey chamber. Just below that, you can find storage of pollen. So we call it as a pollen chamber. Then you can find it other chambers of drone chambers, worker chamber, queen chamber, and larval chamber, and egg chamber, and pupil chambers. Right? The pupil chambers. The hive is like a giant nursery home or factory. Sometimes we cannot tell it is a home because it may be the factory, because they are producing product, they are processing the product, and also producing the offspring. Right? Maybe call it as a factory. Right? Maybe call it as a factory. You see, there are different, I told you, there are different type of cells you can chamber or cell, you can differentiate easily, right? So this is kept flush with the cells. It means the young ones, a leg aid and larval develop, and it is kept. It means from individual kept open and adult will emerge. This is a hole, right? The adult emerged hole, you see? Adult emerged, right? Adult emerged. So these larger chambers are the drone chambers. You see, the drone chamber, the small one are the worker chamber. This is the queen chamber. You see, always vertically, you can find the queen chamber. This is the queen chamber. If you are going very closer, or if you have removed the bees, and you can find it, how these chambers design according to the specific sizes of these, each and every cast and the purposes. This is an engineer, right? Bees are engineers. So how they are developing, how they are measuring, right? This measuring is because of this, and I told you, it's an antennal size. The old hexagonal, all are equal and symmetry. Right? It's an engineering technology developed by the these insects. So these bees, from the emergence, they cannot be lazy. Every day and every minute, they have to work and will die. Therefore, from the birth, the job assigned by the queen, right? So queen, queen is an order, right? So order mother, right? So order mother and the head of the family, woman-headed family. So this, from the birth, if they are lazy, then there will be some, you know, some of the conflict may arise if you are free. If you are busy, you will not think other things, right? You will be work. That's the thing. So our faculty and the arts faculty, the claps are less because our students are very busy with the studies. So arts faculty students are not busy with the study. Then there will be a clashes. Right? Like that, from the birth, the job is assigned. So 1 to 12 days, we call it as a nurse bees. Right? 10 to 20 days old, we call it as a house bee. So 12 days old, nurse bee, 20 days old bee, house bee. So house security, thereafter house bee, and house security bees mean guard bees. Field agent, we call it as a forage bees. Right? Field agents, we call it as a forage bees, especially 3 weeks, ready to spend rest of their lives in the forage, gathering of nectar and resin. And this is a short term, and the short classification I will discuss from these slides, the longer classification. From first day to second day, cell cleaning, right? Immediately after the birth, second day. So their role is, as a first year student, you entered it, right? So your role is labor work, like that. So the cell cleaning, whatever the brood chambers dead or attracted by the pest, or if there is a cast and mold exudates are there, they should go and visit and they should clean all these things. There we call it as a cleaning bee, cell cleaning bees. The age of 1 to 2 days, second day, 2 days, first 2 days, cleaning job. Right? Cleaning phase will be performed, this cleaning. If not clean, worker bee must do it again. Right? That is mean teaching. Worker, mature worker will help it. If it is not clean properly, work mature worker bee, teach them to clean. Right? Teach them to clean. So second, from third day to 11th day, nurse bee. Nursing bee, giving the food for queen, giving the food for young larvas, giving the food for drones. Drones will not eat alone. Queen will not eat alone. Young ones will not eat alone. So the workers have to, like a mum, right? Like a mum, so they have to feed. They feed the worker larva, worker jelly, secreted from the same gland to produce the royal jelly. That's what I do. This one, worker jelly, is sometimes call it as a bee milk. Worker jelly is called it as a bee milk. This is a gland we call it as a hypopharyngeal gland of the worker bee. It produces a bee milk as well as a royal jelly, depending on the order given by a queen. Right? If it is royal jelly is produced, it is definitely given to the particular one larva to develop as a queen. Right? And 6 to 11 days, advanced nurse. Advanced nurse means, so bees feed royal jelly to the queen larva. You see, young nurse bee cannot feed the royal queen, future royal queen. Right? Future queen. So if it is reached 6 to 11 days, mean become bit mature, then advanced nursing to me, royal queen larva will be fed by these advanced nurse bees. And also drone receives worker jelly for 1 to 3 days. Drones also they have to feed. They are moved to honey and pollen. So only 3 days for 11 days, 6 to 11 days for 3 days, they have to feed the drone. From 12 to 7 days, so 11 days, 11 years completed, 11 days of age. From 12 to 17 days, there are other more jobs. One is the wax production. So wax gland, at the time, wax gland will be mature and started to secrete wax. So their task is to produce wax. So then build the cells, repair the old cells, store the nectar and pollen and brought by the other worker bees and seal, right? So this is a home works, like home building works. We call it as a home building works because they are producing wax. So they have to repair the homes and store the food, honeys and pollen and seal it, right? Space between the several abdominal segments. So this is wax excluded by the some of these cells we call it as a wax gland present in the abdominal segment of these workers, right? 4 sets of wax gland situated inside the last 4 ventral segment of the abdomen. Last 4 ventral segment of the abdomen modified as a wax gland. It produces wax for home construction. Then honey sealing. So this is home building. This is honey sealing. So the foraging bee will be bring Freud bee will bring the pollen and nectar. Right? So nectar will be processed as honey. Once it's processed as the honey, it will be put in the home and will be sealed for the future use. That's honey we are stealing. That's honey we are stealing, right? So mature honey sufficiently dried and sealed tightly with the wax to prevent the absorption of the moisture from the air by workers disputed to do the same. Right? So this, why? So honey sealing because, so during the process of honey, so during the process they are removing all the water. Why? The fanning bees are there. Some bee jobs are fanning. So they will fan it and remove all the excess water. Like fanning we are giving for drying, air drying. That's how these fanning bees. So their task is to fan to remove the water from this nectar. Processed nectar. Mean? So the bees are collecting nectar from the flowers. Right? This flower, the nectar will be there in the honey chamber. I told you. They will not drink it. It will not digest it. It will be stored in the honey chamber. Again, these bees we call it as a foraging bee who are collecting the nectar and the honey we call it as a foraging bee. They will bring those pollen and the forage, the nectars. This nectar will be sucked by mouth and mouth by the, who are the people, the honey processing bees. Right? They will suck it from the honey chamber. Right? So this will exaggerate like vomiting. Right? From the honey chamber, they will vomit like this nectar. These honey processors just drink that one. Again, it will process the mixing with it, their saliva and process as a honey. This honey, young honey, is consist of a lot of water. So before the storage, they have to remove all the waters. Right? Otherwise, their microbial contamination, things will happen. No? So they will, fanning bees, continuously move the wings to remove excess water. Therefore, the pure honey will be stored in the honey chamber. That's how this is an indication. If somebody is bringing the honey to sell to you, your home, how you will check if this is a sugar solution or pure honey? Right? To take a drop of honey from that bottle and drop, leave it that drop into the clean water in the glass. If the drop fits, right? Immersing into the water, if the size not is reduced, the size of the drop is not reducing, it's indication that there is no water. Or if you are putting a drop of water in a paper and allow it maybe 5 minutes, if it is not, paper is not getting wet, it is indicating that it's a pure honey. And you can check from the consumer if you want to buy a pure honey. The sellers are selling the pure honey or not, you can check it. Why? So these bees are storing the pure honey. And drone feeding, so 12 to 7 days, drones do not feed themselves. They are fed by the workers, these 12 to 7 days old workers. And queen attendant bees, like the queen labors, no? Queen for the queen. If you are thinking that if the country queen means, there are a lot of workers, right? Lot of workers to assist the queen. So beautify the queen, take the bath the queen, to food the queen, right? So like that, the queen attending bees, some groups, right, can attend the queen duties. So the groom and feed the queen. So mean grooming. Grooming the queen, mean decorating like that, right? Beautifying the queen. They also collect queen mendifula perone, right? Queen is also producing a hormone we call as a mandibular hormone. This mandibular hormone is very important for the chemical communication with all the members in the hive. So therefore, these attendant bees take this pheromone and again give it to the others. That's what always, if you are going there in the honey cave, always they will touch with an antenna to antenna, transferring these signals, like chemical signals. Queen and share it to bees around them who also share the spreading of its effect through the hive. Cool. Right? grooming, feed the queen, and collect the queen mandibular pheromone. Others cannot attend the queen. All the members cannot meet the queen. Right? They have to get the permission from these people, queen attendants. The duty is allocated to them to attend the queen. Honeycomb building. Right? Workers will take wax and wax producing workers and build the comb. These home builders are some of the people, like a mason, like an engineers. Some of the group allocated for their target role is to home building. And pollen packer. Some group will work as a pollen packing. It means foraging bee, no? Foraging bees bringing the pollen and honey, nectar. So these pollens will be there in the hind leg of the honeybees as a pack. We call it as a hind leg of the honeybee, we call it as a pollen packs. From there, they have to take the pollen and mix with their saliva, and they have to store it for future needs. Every time they cannot collect pollen, no? So winter season, they need food, no? So they have to store the pollen. So this pollen packer, right? Pollen packing people, what they will do is, so they will, their role is to brought by the forage bees, they have to store it. Right? So pollen brought into the hive for feeding the brood is also stored. It must be packed by firmly, right? And matured small amount of honey so that it will not spoil. They are mixing with honey and spoil it. Unlike the honey, it does not support the bacterial life. Right? Unlike honey, which doesn't support the bacteria, stored pollen will become a rancid without proper care. So kept in the honey cells. It will be rancid now. So therefore, the pollen packer's role is to just pack the pollen properly. Right? Propolizing. Right? Propolizing means sometimes you know that one. So how the hive is hanging from the branch. Without full down. Why? How? So because they are producing wax, and also along with the wax, some are producing propolysin. See, propolis. So the propolis is a resinous substance. So this can help to stick the wax in other homes and seal. It's a mix with an enzymes, right? Combination with the enzyme added by the worker that have antibacterial, antifungal properties. That's how this propolis, people nowadays, they are mixing to the paint. Why? So in the rainy season or wet season, your walls or tiles will not get mold. Some antifungal properties are there. Antibacterial properties are there. Right? The propolis is also used to close off excessive ventilation in entrance. If somewhere and a hive is not closed, excess ventilations are there, immediately this propolizing bee, what will what they will do? Immediately close all these doors like this by making these bags and the propolizing. And much, so mortuary bees. Mortuary bees, somebody is dead, right? Some pest attack or somebody aged, honeybees are dead. Mortuary bees, they will do the morning germinating. These people, only that, this is which you see, it's like a harsh system. Right? Dead bees and failed larvae must remove from the hive to prevent the disease, allow the cell to be reused. They will be carried some of the distance and hive by the mortuary bee. Morning germinating, they will produce the morning pheromones. So morning pheromones mean the people allocated for the morning germinating, they will carry these dead things and other things, they will throw somewhere else. They will not keep inside the heap. You see how they are doing the duties performed. They are group. Efficiently working with the one order. Like a milk bees. Like a milk bees. And fanning bees. Their job is from the morning bee fanning. Right? Continuously fanning to evaporate the excess water. And to maintain the temperature inside the hive. You see, if in the high temperature or low temperature, bees have to survive. No? How they are surviving? So because of this ventilation, we are using an air condition and the control modified room fans. These bees, the group of people, their role is to fan, right? Fanning direct airflow into the hive and out of the hive depending on the need. Change the direction of the wind to maintain the temperature and the aerage. 18 to 21 days, they are mature, no? Bit mature. So their role is to change. Their role will be changed. So others will substitute, right? Because continuously they are producing offspring, no? At the age, they are transferring their jobs. Like a transfer and promotions. Like a promotion from the labor, technical officer, attendant, technical officer, senior, or like the probation, temporary demonstrator, assistant lecturer, lecturer probation, senior lecturer, and the head of the department, dean, vice chancellor, like that, professors, right? So days 18 to 20 days, 21 days, guard bees. Yeah, now mature people know, so they can guard, they can do the defense. So protect the hindrance hive from enemies. Their role is to, as a security role. They will be there in the right doors or entry points. They will check it. If somebody, enemies are there, unwanted people are there, they will alarm the hive. They will produce, be called as an alarming pheromone. Somebody is there, please come and attack and kill them. It's be called as an alarming pheromone. And also they have the string. Immediately they will attack it. If more people are coming or if it is not attacked, that it is going to die, it will produce alarm pheromone. So many people will come, so then group will attack. That's all. If you are throwing stone, first one bee immediately come and bite you. Right? If it is, the biting bee is died, if it is in the sting broken, definitely what they will, it will emit the alarming pheromone, then group of enemies will come and attack you. Right? And soldier bees. The soldier hang around the near an entrance and attack invaders. So guard bees and soldier bees, soldiers go here and there. If there are some invaders, they will monitor it, right? They work into connect with an entrance guard. Right? Concert with an entrance guards. Entrance guard bees. Entrance guard mean so they will always in the door, like front gate, faculty front gate security. If one person is going and coming in from somewhere else, he will check like temperature taking and spraying, cleaning hands like the COVID-19. He will, all he or she, they are workers, no? She will inspect incoming bees to ensure they are bringing the food or they having correct hive order. They are coming in the same hive or some others cannot come, no? Their colony. If some other people cannot come in their home, they will check it. And if the bees will be rejected or attacked by the soldier, if somebody is coming from other hive, they will attack and kill it. Because these are not members. That's the thing. So hive order. Hive order, whether they are bringing food or not. So if they are going for the forage, they will cheat and they should not come back. They will bring the food. Otherwise, this person will not allow. Change. And outside guard bees. Outer guard may be short flights around the outside the hive in response to disturbances. That's how if you are going there very close to your hive, any hive, you will find first sound, kissing sound. We call it as a kissing sound. Why they are producing kissing sound mean? They are alerting their hives by moving their wings, right? So the hive, somebody is coming close. If it is disturbed, few people, few people will fly. These people are called as an outside guard bees to check what is happening around. Right? And water carrying bees. So these people, their role is to go somewhere else where the water is available. They have to bring it the water. Because water is needed to pack the pollen and make the hives with the wax, mixing with the wax, they have to mold it, right? And bring it back and spread the back and fanning bees. You obtain the water usually with short distance. I bring it back to spread on the back of fanning bees. Why? You see, water carrying bees, what they are doing? The fanning bees are fanning now. The temperature is high. They are spraying the water closer to the wings. Then, so cool moisture will be fan, like the cooling fans are available nowadays. No? We are putting the ice cream cubes and fan will be rotating. So cool air will come if there is no AC. Like this, how it is working, you see, magic, right? Imagine. And 22 to 35 days, foraging bees, fully matured, then their role is to, from the guard roles and other roles, they will be foraging bees. Foraging bees, so forager and scout bees travel 2 to 5 miles to collect the nectar and pollen source and collect the propolis. Or to collect the propolis. Propolis is some of these substances and mixed with the, their enzymes, they are making as a sticky substances, right? You see, foraging bees, they have to go for the collection of nectar, or pollen source and propolis. These foraging bees are two types. One is a scout bees. Scout bees mean this person will go somewhere else where the pollen sources, honeys are available, and he will come back again and communicate with that other foraging bees where it is located, how much is there. Through dancing, we call it as physical communications. And I will discuss in the maybe next class or this class, right? We call it as a dancing bees. Right? We call it as a dancing bees, or the foraging bees and scouting bees. Scouting bees can do dance, right? Scouting bees can do the dance. We call it as a transfer of information to the foraging bees or pollen collect and nectar collecting bees. Die in field. So these bees can die because the mature bee know dying in somewhere else, not in the home. Lifespan of the workers depend on the time of the year, and more worker bees live about 28 to 35 days. However, the bees are treated rare in September and October, can live through the winter. Can be even in the year season, European countries, right? European countries or temperate countries, in the winter season they can survive. Otherwise, so these in 35 days in hot summer, or these food is shortage less, they have aged, then they will die after 35 days. Right, from the birth and the die, different age, different roles. This is very important. You should know that and how these assigned jobs. That's what we call this one as a factory. The factory people, so raw material collection people, processing people, packaging people, marketing people, like that. This is also industry. Different people and different age group, different jobs. There is no conflict. They have to do the jobs, right? So these, I told you, the foraging bees and queen producing pheromones, queen communications, and everything will be, we call it as a, every information is passed without the 4G, 5G networks very efficiently, 25 to 50,000 members within a second. How it is happening? This is, we call it as a communications in honeybees. Right? Communication is in honeybees. There are two types of communications. Right? In the honeybees, there are two types of communication. One is the chemical communication. So chemical communications mean pheromones. There are lot or different types of pheromone produced by the different workers and the queen. Right? So commonly, queen pheromone, queen is produce a substance we call it as a 2-oxo-2-9-oxo-2-decanoic acid or 9-ODA. Right? 9-oxo-2-decanoic acid or 9-ODA is a very popular queen pheromone produced by the mandibular queen or mandibular gland of the queen. So this is very important to maintain the social cohesion, right? Social cohesion and to prevent the homeostasis. Homeostasis means if this substance is not produced, I told you, worker bees develop, ovary will be developed. Workers never obey the queen and kill the queen or peck the queen and throw the queen, right? So the colony cohesion and suppression of the development of the ovaries in workers, queen has to produce these hormones continuously, right? For colony cohesion and suppression of development of ovaries in workers, there are made two major role of these hormones. If it is short supply of these substances, I told you social homeostasis. Severely disturbed, even the colony will become an orphan colony. There is no queen because workers have killed or the queen is died. No communication, chemical communication, no control. Orphan colony. If the orphan colony is there, then who will take the initial role? If there is no prime minister or president is died, who will take the response? And the next authority is to worker bees. One few worker bees, they will decide whether is there any brood, meaning larva is there, and they will decide to develop the one of the larva as queen. Right? They will develop one of the larva as a queen. From that queen, then again colony will be developed. Otherwise, if it's an orphan colony, finally, this colony will, you cannot rear this colony. Colony will be dismantled. If there are some brood, then definitely then these workers develop one of these brood as a social homeostasis. So that's how. So always the queen will be there inside the hive. If it is going outside, I told you one time or two time it will fly. We call that, that's what we call, that fly is called as a marital flight or nuptial flight. On the nuptial flight only the queen will fly and it will come within a 30 to 40 minutes time. If it is not coming, then this concentration of this queen pheromone 9-ODA will be declined. Again, this worker will be become aggressive and try to kill or peck the queen, a rolling of queen, pecking or queen pecking, queen rolling, right? It will happen. Finally, the queen will die. This colony will become an orphan. Right? Often. So for the chemical communication, that's what I told you, the queen pecking and queen bowling will happen if this queen is removed or short for a short period or this written colony bees start to peck. So intricate association interaction between the queen and workers could easily be seen formation of the queen court. This continuous production of the queen, right, continuous production 9-ODA hormone. I told you the queen attending bee will collect that 9-ODA and distribute all over the colony. It is we called as a queen court. That's how around the queen, workers will be always there. That is we called as a queen court. I told you in the few among the slides I put a picture. You would have seen that one. Here, this is a picture. So this is a queen. Around the queen, you can see there are a lot of members. This is because we call it as a queen cord transferring this. They are receiving signal, queen cord. Right? So queen cord. The formation of queen cord is essential to prevent the to maintain the social homeostasis of colony. And pheromone secreted by the tragic glands of the queen is essential to cord for the formation and stabilizes. Another one is there, we call it as an alarm pheromone. Alarm pheromone, which initiates a stinging behavior, it is produced by the stinging apparatus, alarming pheromone. That's what the guard bees, if it is sting you, attracted the enemies, their sting will break down. If it is breaking down, then it will emit the hormone we call it as an alarming pheromone. So if it is an alarming pheromone emitted for the spot, many bees will come with an aggressive and bite the enemies. The alarming pheromone is produced by the stinging apparatus. Another one is the orientation pheromone. Orientation pheromone produced by the Nesenov gland. Nesenov means the scientist who discovered the gland present in the worker bees. Nesenov gland at the tip of the abdomen of the worker. So well-known worker pheromone. This is a well-known worker pheromone, means orientation pheromone. This orientation pheromone will be secreted for when the morning, if somebody is dying, morning for the morning ceremony, right? For the morning of funeral. So they will produce orientation pheromone to do this ceremony. Or if they want to allocate some of the more duties or immediately communicate the whole company to orient these members, they will produce orientation. These hormones play a major role for swami. This orientation pheromone major role is to produce swami. Swami means if you are rearing one wife, right? Food is abundant. So they will produce so much of workers and drones. Too many colony now. What they will do is the queen will order the worker to produce orientation pheromone to remove the partial group, right? Partial group of the hive, and to develop a new queen to go somewhere else to start a life, new life, as a new hive, in a new hive. That process we called as a swarming. Processes we call as swarming. Swarming means moving of the separated colony to somewhere else to initiate a new life. We call it as a swarming. This is commonly you can expect in the termite, ants, locust, honeybees. We call it as termite swarming. Swarming. Termites in the some of the rainy days you can find it. Termite with wings. Lot of termites with wings. You mean they are swarming. Population is abundant, they are going somewhere else to initiate a new. That is, we call as swarming. So all the termites will not survive. All the wing termites will not survive. So whichever the termite is surviving from falling the wings and get mated and going inside the soil, again, they will make a new colony in the termites. That is different story, right? Like, you know, don't confuse with the honeybees. Is one of the work orientation pheromone role is to swami. Other than this, all these pheromones produced by the queen and the worker, the main target is to cohesion. How they can work joint together, colony mating. And mating, queen is producing some of these hormones we call it as an for nuptial flight, marriage flight. Before that, they will produce a particular hormone. Then these drones will be activated and drone will fly and congregate in an area around the air tree interface we call it as a drone congregation area. The wedding ceremony hall like that. Then queen will fly and get mated. It's a drone congregation area for mating purpose. Absconding. Absconding in if the many people is get deceased, this colony will go into abscond. So somewhere else, if they should leave that diseased people, healthy people will go somewhere else to make a new home. This we call absconding. And swami, without queen, this is absconding means there is no queen. I was absconding. Swami, a stinging. So in many other behaviors are important of social integration and survival. For that, they are producing hormones for the fittest to the survival. So that is the chemical communication. Other one is their physical communication. I am going to stop here with, if you want to ask any question, please you can ask. I will continue the physical communication and the rest of the part in the next class. If you want to ask any question, please ask.